keep distance. While I make the long way home, trucks on highways hauling hundreds of my brothers and sisters haunt me with gaudy artwork, impossible to ignore, imploring me to keep distance. No longer is it an irritating reminder of endless hours in a truck grazing shoulders under the blazing sun, inhaling fumes at leisure. But everywhere I look, everywhere I turn, I am reminded to keep distance, making me wonder. Isn't my story the story of keeping distance, of staying far away from you? Keeping distance from my difference, keeping distance from my danger, keeping distance from the unknown, letting me remain unknown. Isn't my story about your fear of me, to protect you from me? All that matters is your self-preservation. This is the land of my forefathers. I'm what they term indigenous. Your forefathers arrived yesterday in time, yet you call me Mlecha. My dark skin frightens you. Your stories refer to me as Rakshasa, Asura, placing my origins in the netherworld. My roots are in the nether regions of the country. That makes all of me nether to you. Your laws of Manu forbid me approach your shadow. My presence pollutes you. You call me Paria. Your sacred cow is no more sacred when dead, merely a carcass I must carry away to make your leather belt and shoes with which to whip and kick me if I fail to keep distance. It is okay for you, Sahib, to sleep with my wife, leaving your footwear outside my door as a warning for me to stay away. But if my son eloped with your daughter, you would have me lynched and the lovers killed to protect your honor, because they didn't keep distance. I must exist unseen on the outskirts of our village. I dare not claim you as neighbor, but I must do your every bidding. If I thirst, you'd rather have me wither than drink water from your well, which I dug for you. It's your world. It, with the power you wield, nothing I do could level the playing field. So I ran away to the city. But you were there too. Now whom do I turn to for succor, for a roof over my head? The crooked politician purchased my vote for the price of booze and biryani. His cronies offered his protection, at least till the next election, my troubles would keep distance. I earn 20 lakh zeros less than you. That's my net worth. Insurance cover. Yes, a plastic helmet on my head to protect your butt from my negligence while I build your villa, your tech park, your mall, your metro, your flyovers in blazing sun and scorching heat. For me, I'm on the highway to hell. I am the tormented. You're the devil. If I thirst en route, there's a tumbler of water left on the wall. Is it Aru purified? I can't even ask, because you've done it to keep distance. My wife's the maid sweeping your floors, cooking your food, babysitting, doing odd jobs in the neighborhood so that our kids can dream of better days with the right to education, while your CCTV's keeping a watchful eye, making sure we keep distance. One construction site to the next, one slum to the next, from one meal to the next. This life's a penal colony for past sins. While you're safe and secure, protected from mine and me within your gated community that I built, it must feel so reassuring to know you can afford to keep distance. You're the Indian, you're the model citizen. To prove who I am, I must register, or else I'm illegal, a foreigner, in the land of my forefathers, a Mlecha, merely a migrant worker, nothing more. Mazdoor, yes. Mazboor, no. It's bad enough you've locked me out, left me homeless, hungry, mired in misery on the streets. Now you want me locked down, held back against my will, to kickstart your failing economy. Governments dance to your tune, cause they are in the palm of your hand. I am through with you and your devious ways. No more do what I say. Your insistence will meet with resistance. Come the next voting day, you will be well advised to keep distance. You think I care about your portfolio value or losses to your corporation when I have zero net worth? You think I care if your kids aren't going to school or who is going to clean your swimming pool? I am through with being your migrant worker. I am through being the nation's tearjerker on TV. I'm nearly home. It's taken forever. I'm too exhausted to see tomorrow, forget the day after or the future. I'm too bleary-eyed to see the way forward. Besides, it doesn't matter to me. The fringes of my village are my destiny. Before I put you and all that you stand for behind me, all I want to say is this. Stay the fuck away from me. Or in plain simple trucking parlance, keep distance.